Hello, welcome to my channel once again. This your boy Kamma Dyn. As you know, I've not been very consistent on my channel. Yes, because you know what I do. I do architectural drawings and I also build. So sometimes I'll be on site and I'm supposed to supervise some projects for clients and all that. So you know, sometimes some people find it difficult purchasing land the right way. You know, some people find it difficult purchasing land in Ghana the right way. So some of them go through a lot. Even some of them lose their lands to some parties and all that. So I'm basically here to give you the guidelines that you can use to purchase land successfully in Ghana. I'm here to give you five top things that you need to do to know whether this land that you are buying is genuine or not. Top five things that you need to do for you to ascertain and know this land that I'm buying is genuine or not. The first point that I'm going to give you is searching or inquiring about who actually owns that particular plot of land. For instance, you have gone to a particular place, you've seen the area, you are interested in that particular land in that particular area. You've seen the land. Perhaps you asked around, they showed you the owners, and you went there to speak to them or to talk to them that you are interested in buying their land. I will tell you, first of all, when you approach them, one thing that you need to let them know is that, yes, you are interested in the land, you want to buy this particular land, but what you want to do is, you want to do what? Make a search from the lands commission to know that whether the land actually belongs to them or not. And there is a way that you can go about this. You just have to find a land surveyor. Get a land surveyor, let the land surveyor do what? Pick that portion of the land. And the land surveyor or the draftman, whoever you get, or the architect, will take the site plan that the surveyor. Sometimes you will not find a land surveyor. Perhaps you know an architect or a draftman or something. You can talk to that person and definitely they have a surveyor. So they will lead you to that surveyor. The surveyor will come and pick that particular portion of land and plot the site plan and do what? Take it to the lands commission for a search. Usually, when you go to lands commission, they will tell you whether your land is estate land or it is not estate land. Maybe it is vested or it is not vested. Any issue, anything, any, or if the land has already been registered in someone's name, they will tell you. You understand? And mostly when you go and they tell you that, hey, the land belongs to this person or this particular person has registered, then the person who is selling the land to you has to be the same person that has his or her name at the lands commission that person did what? Did that registration. If the name or the person selling the land to you, the name of that person doesn't correspond with the name that you find at lands commission, then there is a problem. You should know that then there is a problem. So a land like that, you need to distance yourself from it. You understand? You need to distance yourself from it. Because it cannot be that a different person is selling the land to you and you going to lands commission to make your search, then the name that you find there too is a different name. It doesn't work that way. You understand? So if that happens, distance yourself from that property and move to the next. The second point that I'm giving you is, you can also go to the same area. That's the area that the land is situated. You can ask around, ask anybody, especially the locals that live around. Ask them, hey, this land, don't even tell them you are interested in buying land. Just ask them, this land that is lying here, or this land, this particular land belongs to who? Or you want to know the owner of this particular land. You just tell them you want to know the owner of this particular land. And I'm telling you, they will tell you the owner, the real owner. And if there is any problem on that particular land, they will also tell you. If there is any problem on that particular land, they will tell you. You will hear from the locals. And I always say, it is one of the best searches that you can make when buying land in Ghana. The people around, they know the stories. If there are land guards coming around, if there is a dispute on that particular land, if there is anything on that land, they are the people, the best people, who are going to tell you this or this or that. Yes. Okay, so my third point that I'm also giving you is, sometimes someone might have a land and perhaps the person has taken that property to go in for a facility at the bank, maybe a loan at the bank, you know? And sometimes these things happen. So you can make your search at the collateral registry. Yes, we have a collateral registry that you can make your search there to also know that whether anyone or any person or the owner who wants to sell that particular land for you to you has not used that particular property as a collateral to take any facility from the bank. You understand? So if that happens, if you can make that search too, you understand? Yes, you can make that search too. Exactly. All these things happen sometimes, so be very careful out there if you want to buy any land. And let me tell you this, you are not going to be the one, or you the client, you are not going to be the one who is going to go through all these processes. You can find a professional to do all these things for you. You can find a professional to do all these things for you. You don't have any problem. You can find a professional to do all these things for you. Okay, so my fourth point is when they tell you, or perhaps when you see the owner or the person who says the land belongs to them, when you see the person, what you need to do, you can also tell the person that, please, I want to see the document covering, the legal document covering this particular land. And that person has to have that document, that legal document covering, because it's like a car. You've bought a car. If the car belongs to you, definitely you need to have the papers or the document covering that particular car. You understand? So, same as land. If the land belongs to you, show me the legal document. And this that I'm saying, if you don't know how to check these documents, even if the person has it and you don't know how to check these documents, what I will advise is get a professional, go with the person and let the person check for you the documents that will be provided for you. You understand? The documents that will be provided for you. Check all these documents and get to know whether the documents are genuine or not. You understand? And my fifth point that I want to give you is you can also go to the law court. This is another search that you can make, or checks that you can make at the law court, to also know whether there is any pending litigation on that said land. There is any pending litigation on that said land. Maybe there is a dispute on the land, you don't know. And maybe two of, like, one of the parties just passed at the back of the other party or the court and just decided to sell the land to you. You don't know. You can buy a land like that and later you can have a problem. You can buy a land like that and you can later have a problem. So try also knowing that if that particular land has a pending litigation, like if there is any litigation on that particular land. Yes, I think these are the 5 points that I'm going to give you on you purchasing land in Ghana. At least if you are able to do these things, you will know, you will at least know that, hey, if there is any problem with the land, you will know. If there is no problem with the land too, you will know. You understand? With all these points that I've given you, if you go through all these things, I'm telling you, you can buy a genuine land in Ghana. And as I told you, you are not going to go through all this stress. Just find a professional and let that professional do all these things. You, the client, you are just going to pay the professional for the professional to do all these searches for you. You understand? Before you buy that particular land. So, thank you for watching. I will bring you the next video. I'm actually making it a series. So, after making your search and everything, the next thing that you need to do, the next video, in the next video, I will say all that also in the next video. So, watch out for the next video also. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.